Hey guys, it's R5 Webkins, 1678 here, and I'm here with Taffy, the Delights Candy Puppy, and Cookie, the Springer Spaniel. I decided to bring Cookie here for a reason. I decided that today I would make homemade chocolate chip cookies. Let's begin. For this recipe, you are going to need 2 cups of semi-sweet chocolate chips, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 2 teaspoons of hot water, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 3 cups of all-purpose flour, 2 teaspoons vanilla extract, 2 eggs, 1 cup packed brown sugar, 1 cup of white sugar, and 1 cup of butter softened. And remember, you should always start off your recipe by cleaning all kitchen utensils. And for this recipe, you're going to need 2 washed measuring cups and 2 spoons, 1 big one and 1 small one. To start off, I'm going to take 1 huge spoon of butter and keep scooping until I have 1 cup. I'm going to pour this into the measuring cup. You don't specifically have to use this butter. I use it because it's kind of like a cheat. It comes softened for you. It's kind of like that butter that you use for your bread or your toast. So instead of having to soften at least 4 of those sticks of butters, you can just use this because it's already softened for you. You can choose to blend 4 sticks of butter together to make 1 cup, but I'd rather use this since it's already softened and it's much easier, taking up only 2 minutes rather than 30. Once you have 1 full cup of butter, you can put away your butter so it's not going to melt for further use. And just an important tip, this will be short and easy. Just so you know, if you hit your spoon too hard on a plastic bowl like that, it's going to break, like I just did. Now you're going to need 1 cup of sugar. It may seem like a lot, but you're going to need it for your recipe to turn out great. You can use the same measuring cup if you want, because it's not like the butter will ruin it since it needed this butter, and it's just going to help you get out the rest of it. So now I'm going to pour 1 cup of sugar. And just to make it clear, first we're going to use white sugar. Now you're going to need 1 cup of packed brown sugar. I never spoke up, yeah, never said hello. But I keep on trying to find a way to meet ya. I was chilling, you were with me. Now we're going to need 2 eggs. It doesn't matter which kind, brown or white. Now you're going to need 2 teaspoons of pure vanilla extract. For this, you're going to need to use your small spoon. As you can see, it's a little dirty with butter since I placed my large spoon on it so it wouldn't dirty the counter, but that's all right. It's all going in the same bowl. Keep in mind, you're going to need to fill this twice and pour it in the bowl twice before you have 2 teaspoons of pure vanilla extract. Need 3 cups of all-purpose flour. This sounds like a lot compared to the sugar. It doesn't mean that 1 cup of sugar isn't a lot. It just means that there's more flour compared to the sugar. Since this measuring cup only holds 2 cups, you will need to pour out the 2 cups into the big bowl of ingredients, and you will need to fill up 1 more cup and then pour it in. Need 1 teaspoon of baking soda. This is very little, but it's all you need to make those cookies rise. As you can see in the little picture down here, those are cookies. Keep in mind that 1 teaspoon is, again, the little spoon, not the big one. Now, I'm going to use 2 teaspoons of hot water. This is obviously not 2 teaspoons. 2 teaspoons, again, would be 2 of the small spoon, but I'm honestly not sure why you need water at all, or hot water, so let's just get going. Now you're going to need the smallest amount you ever have and will need, 1/2 teaspoon. If you have a small measuring spoon, half a teaspoon, that's great. But I don't think I have one, so I'm going to use half of this spoon, maybe up to here, only a little circle in the center. That will be of salt. I've been trying to get you to see this. Now for the best part. You're going to need 2 cups of semi-sweet chocolate chips. And by the way, you will only need 1 bag. Now I'm going to be mixing with a fork. I know it sounds odd and you're probably thinking, what? But that's how ingredients pass through, and then you can mix easier. Now that the batter is fully mixed, you're going to need a baking pan any size, and you might need 2 or 3, and you're going to need to cover it with tin foil. Before you place the cookies on the baking sheets, you're going to need to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Before grabbing the cookies, you'll need flour on your hands to make sure that
the cookies don't fall apart.
Your cookies should look just like this, no bigger or smaller. Now we need to put the cookies in the oven and bake them for at least 30 minutes or until they're golden brown. Now that the cookies have baked for exactly 25 minutes, they should be ready. There may be a little bit flour, but that's all right.